Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Today we are going to isolate DNA from the fungal culture. Why do we isolate DNA from the fungal culture? Because when we do identification by using the morphological tools, we cannot identify up to species level. We can find by the morphological characterization, we can find that this is the culture of Fusarium. We have isolated it from the chili, but we do not know whether this culture, the species of this culture, it cannot be determined by using the morphological tools. They have got same conidia, they have got same hyphae, the length and width of the fungal hyphal cells, they are same, and in most of the cases they have got the same number of septations, average same number of septations. So how can we identify these fungal cultures up to the species level? For this purpose, we sequence, we get them sequenced, we isolate the DNA, and various part of the DNA, various primers, by using various primers, we can identify the species of this fungal culture. So the things which are required for the isolation of the DNA are, first of all, we will be needing a pure culture, an actively growing culture, or full culture plate. You can see the whole culture plate is filled with the fungi, fungal growth. Other than the fungal culture, you will be needing a sterilized pestle and mortar, DNA extraction buffer, phenyl chloroform isoamyl alcohol, isopropanol, sodium acetate. These both are chilled. They have to be placed inside the refrigerator. Then 70% ethanol and the TE buffer. Harvesting of the fungal mass from the culture plate, we will be needing a surgical blade. Then we also will be needing the micropipette, 1000 microliter, 100 microliter, 10 200 microliter, and then 5 to 10 microliter. Then we will also be needing the micro tips for the pipette, blue tip, yellow tip. And for 5 to 10 microliter, we will be needing small white tips. Then this vortex mixer for the mixing of the pellet. Then we will be needing the centrifuge. It is refrigerated. And the water bath. We will take 5 gram fungal mass. Five milligram fungal mass. We can also use the liquid nitrogen for crushing the fungal mass. We will add 1000 microliter DNA extraction buffer. And 500 microliter ...500 microliter of phenol chloroform isoamide. Then we will crush it again. To crush it thoroughly. Then we will pour it in the Eppendorf tube. After doing the vortex, we will centrifuge it at 10,000 RPM for 10 minutes. Now we will label it and again centrifuge. The 10 minutes has gone. Now we are going to open the door of the centrifuge. After centrifugation, we will take the supernatant with the help of pipette and we will pour it into another Appendorf tube. After taking the supernatant in the new Appendorf tube, we will add 500 microliter isopropanol, which is chilled, and 50 microliter of sodium acetate. We will mix it gently till the appearance of the white thread-like material in it. Now you can see that there are thread-like structures, thread-like material present inside the tube. Then we will again centrifuge at 10,000 RPM, 4 degrees for 10 minutes. After centrifugation again, we take this rotor out and our sample, and you can see a pellet settle down in the bottom of the Eppendorf tube. This is what our DNA is. Now we will remove all the supernatant. Carefully, leaving behind our pellet. Some of the supernatant is left. We are going to will add 70% ethanol. microliter. We'll again centrifuge it. You will again place it. Our sample in the centrifuge. Now, after 10 minutes of centrifugation at 10,000 RPM at 4 degree centigrade, the process has been completed. Now we are going to open the door and we will take our sample in the Eppendorf tube. Now we will remove the ethanol, that is the supernatant, with the help of the micropipette by using a fresh tip. And we will invert the tube on the tissue paper for the 2 hours. After 2 hours, we will add 200 microliter of TE buffer. We will incubate it at 37 degree for 30 minutes. The temperature in this bath, water bath has already been set at 37 degree centigrade for 37 minutes. Now we will place the DNA in the water bath. For 30 minutes. After 30 minutes in the water bath, we will take it out. After taking it out from the water bath at 37 degree centigrade for 30 minutes, if the traces of DNA pellet are still there, we will shake it on the water so that it can get dissolved completely. Now you can see your DNA, it has completely been dissolved in it. Now we will keep it for the observation of the DNA by using gel electrophoresis apparatus, and we will run this DNA on the gel in our next video.